If your team's still waiting on full builds every time someone opens a pull request, you are moving painfully slower than you need to. Here's the old school QA flow. You make a change, open a pull request, wait for a build, send it to QA, they download it, install it, test it, and maybe approve it for production. That loop can take hours, sometimes days, and it kills momentum. Expo blow that whole process wide open. Instead of waiting for builds, you can give QA and your teammates instant previews of every code change. No waiting, no manual distribution, no bottlenecks. Just faster interaction and faster feedback. And yeah, you can do all of this with Expo's CI/CD service, EAS Workflows. Honestly, the simplest setup. But in this video, we're going to do it with GitHub Actions, because that's what most teams already use. And it makes the workflow super relatable. Here's a workflow we are setting up. Whenever you open a pull request, Expo will automatically spin up an over-the-air preview of your changes, something anyone on your team can load on their devices in seconds. And this isn't limited to QA. If you're collaborating with other engineers, this is one of the quickest ways to share what you're working on. They can just open your update inside their development build, see it in context, and give you instant feedback. In this video, I'll show you exactly how to enable pull request previews, how the preview updates are created, and how teams use this setup to iterate faster with Expo. Let's dive in. So I created this example with GitHub Actions. Let me show you a pull request, but this is how it would usually look when you create a pull request against the main branch. First of all, I have some lint checks, tests, and then I create a build so that everyone on my team can install it and check it out. You would usually create a development build at least once the first time that you set up your project. So at this point, I'm pretty sure that everyone has access to this build and they can install it. So instead of building each time that someone creates a pull request against the main branch, we can just create a preview update. It's much faster and allows you to just share a link that everyone with the development build can load and see instantly. So let's see how we can do that. We have a really nice document that we're going to reference that basically explains how to do this step by step. So of course, at this point, I already have enabled GitHub Actions and just want to show you one more thing. When you are building or using updates with GitHub Actions, you're going to need to create an Expo token. Here on the left, if I go to Actions, you are going to see that I already have my Expo token set up. You can create an Expo token just by going to expo.dev and scroll down. You'll see these access tokens. You can create a token here anytime and just name it Expo token. And then you can use this value on the GitHub Actions. So I already have GitHub Actions example app and this value is already set up here. So I don't need to do anything else. I can just go ahead and add an extra workflow. So let's copy this. Let's go to my project. Here I have my GitHub Actions and workflows. Let's create a new file and call it preview.yaml. I'm going to paste the example. So the name is preview and we're going to trigger on each pull request. If you prefer, you can actually do something like this. Just create an update for the main branch. If you're using Bun like me, we actually have a section for that. You just come here and copy this piece of code. And instead of setting up Node, we are going to set up Bun. Now, one more thing, instead of using yarn here, I'm gonna say bun install for the install dependencies step. You can customize the command for EAS update if you want to, but we can just keep it simple for now and leave it as it is. All right, so let's hit save and now we're ready. Now at this point, it's worth mentioning that sometimes when you made native changes to your application, in that case, you need to create a new build because all the development clients that we have so far are not going to be compatible anymore with your changes. So in that case, you cannot use a preview. And in that case, I actually would recommend using EAS workflows because we already have some prepackaged jobs that will handle validating if your changes are compatible with an existing development build. And in that case, it's going to create an over-the-air update. Otherwise, it's going to create a build. If you want to stick with GitHub Actions, you can actually create a custom script and then use Expo Fingerprint to validate if your project is compatible with a previous development build. We won't cover how to do that in this video, but we have documentation that you can reference and I'm going to leave it in the description. Since this is the first time that I'm setting up updates in this project, I need to create a new development build. So what I'm going to do is that instead of building every time that someone creates a pull request against the main branch, I'm just going to change this to be on push. So when someone pushes to main, I'm going to create a build. But if someone creates a pull request against main branch, I'm just going to create an update. Of course, you might need to change this according to your business logic and the changes that you are doing, but just for this example, let's do this. Now, once I have this change, I'm going to commit and push. And push to main. Let's see. Okay, now if I go back to my repo, you can see that we have the GitHub action in progress, and we can see the details here. So this is great. It's building my project. Now we can wait a little bit. But in the meantime, we can actually start working on new features. Let's go to our project and let's actually run the application. So I'm going to start the server by saying npx expo start. Let's run it on iOS. Okay, and this is my app. It's just an app that displays colors. You can see them. These are platform colors, by the way. Let's see how this looks on Android. I'm going to open the application. Okay, and it's using dark mode. We can toggle it. This is how it looks. Platform specific colors for Android. All right, so now we're going to make our changes. All right, so I have made my changes. Now it looks different, as you can see here. Let's clear the terminal and let's create a new branch for my changes, right? This is what you would usually do when you are contributing. So I'm going to create a new branch called my fit, and then let's add the changes. Let's say git commit, update view, and then I can push this and create a pull request. So I'm gonna go back to my repo, create a pull request, my feature, update view, and create a pull request. Now let me actually go to the code. And you can also see that the build was successfully triggered, and you can double check that by going to your project. Let's see how we are doing on the build. So for iOS, the build is done. For Android, is still in progress. But let's go back and let's check my pull request. Now, for a pull request, we're actually running multiple checks. Let's see them here. Test passed, lint passed, and now we are creating a preview update. All right, and after a minute or so, we have now the link preview that we can share with the QA team, teammates, or friends that you want them to test this out. They only need to have a development build installed on their phone, and then they can load all the updates for development and see the previews. So I have here my iPhone. This is an iPhone that I use for testing, and let's pretend that I'm now the QA test team, and I'm going to review this pull request. But before I dive into the code, I want to actually see how this looks like, right? And I don't want to change branch, pull the code, run a simulator, start the server, scan the QR code. That's painful. So we can just use the preview here. But before that, we need to install the development build. So let's go to the builds. We created one for iOS. So let's click on it and let's press install. And I'm just going to scan this QR code by opening the camera and install it. You only need to install the development client every time that you make native changes. But the changes that we created right now are just JavaScript changes, and they are fully compatible with the previous build. So now I can just open the dev build and it's going to work. So I can go back now to the preview here, and let's open the camera again and scan this preview, press on it. And now the development build is going to use this preview so that I can see the changes no matter where you are in the world. Okay, so let's allow, I'm going to continue. And I can see the changes instantly and iterate with the app in real time. So as you can see, this is great feedback because, you know, I can just use my real device, test the changes, and now I can tell the developer, you know what? I think we need some border radius on these squares before I even dive into the code. So let's do the change. Let's pretend that now we want to iterate. Let's go back to the code and we received feedback. So let's add a border radius here. There we go. Now it has border radius. So let's push these changes. When I say our border radius and push the changes, let's go to our branch, and now new changes are coming in, new checks, lint, and update are going to be displayed here in a moment. Okay, while this update is getting done, let's go back to the build and let's install it for Android as well. I have here my real Android device, and you can see here, it's, you know, I can control it, really cool. And now actually this is a good example of why you should use updates instead of builds. If you take a look at the build time for my Android build, it took close to 20 minutes, I mean 16 minutes. It's not that bad, but it adds up on each change. Like right now we only changed the border radius and we should be able to test that quickly, right? So let's install it on my Android device. Let me bring it here. Same deal, we can just open the camera, scan this code. Now this is actually going to take me to the Expo page where I can just press installed. It's going to download it. And after a second, we have now this development build that we can install. Let's install it. Okay, let's open it. Awesome, so now we have the dev client, perfect. Now let's go back to the preview and it's done. And now we can just scan the QR code. Open the camera again, press on the update, and this will load this instantly on my Android device. So these are going to look different on Android, by the way. But yeah, at the end of the day, it's pretty close, like the same functionality, and we can preview colors. At this point, we can just let the QA team know that we made the changes, and we can just open the camera again and scan the QR code. All right, and that's it. So now I'm able to see the changes super nice, super quickly. I didn't have to dive into the code. Now I got a better sense of what this is actually doing. But on top of that, once you have a development build installed on a real iPhone or Android device as well, one cool thing is that this is connected directly to the link on EAS update. So you don't need to have any local servers running. You can just send the link actually to your teammate. And even if they are, I don't know, waiting in the airport, they can see your changes right away in development. So let's go home. Another cool thing that I want to show you is that if you go home here, you can see that we have the updates tab, and you can always come here and see the updates for each channel. So let's log into your Expo account here. Okay, I'm going to enter my credentials and now I'm going to log in as, you know, with my Expo account. And suddenly I'm able to see all the updates here and I can go back and to the latest update. On top of that, you can even check here which updates are compatible with the development build that you have installed so that you don't install anything that is not compatible and it could break your application, or that could mean that you need to install the latest development build. So we can turn that on. We can see that these two are completely compatible with my phone. So I can open the first one and I can quickly see, okay, this is how it looked before. And then I can shake again, go home, go to the updates and load the latest one. And we can do the same on Android, of course. We can shake the device. Let's go home. Let's go to the updates tab and sign in. Okay, I'm going to sign in and then let's select the application to be redirected back. And now I can see the updates here, the latest update. So let's press on it. There we go. We can shake. Let's go home. Let's go to the updates tab. We can see the previous change as well on Android and provide feedback. Now at this point, I can confidently come here and approve this pull request. So let's merge this to main and boom. Now actually this is going to trigger a new development build to make sure that everything is working fine on the main branch. All right, that's it. Now you have pull request previews fully automated with Expo and GitHub Actions. No more waiting on slow builds, no more sending binaries around, just instant over-the-air previews for every pull request. Your whole team can load changes in seconds and give feedback immediately. Now, if you want to take this even further, I highly recommend checking out EAS Workflows. They come with pre-compiled jobs, testing, building, and releasing, and most teams adopt them gradually. You don't need to switch your entire pipeline overnight. Start with something simple, like setting up previews or automating your release builds, and expand from there. But if you prefer staying on GitHub Actions, that's totally fine too. We have documentation that go much deeper into advanced patterns, triggers, artifacts, and other CI setups that you can build on. And if you want more examples, I've got additional videos on the channel covering EAS workflows, previews, and full release pipelines. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.